1919, The Industrial Revolution in Britain. Great Britain, the nation made of Scotland, Wales, and England in 1707, was the center of what is known today as the Industrial Revolution. The revolution was not planned or pre-designed. It happened thanks to a combination of multiple factors that merged in the country during the late 18th century. History is contingent, so what happened in Britain was the consequence of a unique combination of events, possibilities, and constraints. One of the most critical discussions on the origins of the Industrial Revolution is why it did happen in Western Europe and not in other places equally advanced at the time, like East Asia. The answer to this question is complicated and continues to stir debate among economists and historians. Most people argue that in Britain, there were things like coal, a centralized government, a strong culture, skilled artisans, bankers, and a lot of money from global trade and slavery that motivated people to have a capitalist machine power system of production. Besides material reasons, Britain also had plenty of intellectual activity. The scientific revolution and the Enlightenment fostered new knowledge, and there was a tradition to share intellectual progress. Ideas about the importance of research, experimentation, and science spread quickly within ordinary people and political leaders. Economically, Britain had used the 17th century to develop a substantial textile industry. Woolen cloth was exported to many places worldwide, including China and India. The consequence of this export was an economic surplus, commercial profits, and high wages. The mercantilist economic system had produced tremendous wealth for the country, and thanks to its privileged position in Latin America and the Atlantic trade, Britain had an ample supply of raw materials and human labor. These two factors helped in the consolidation of the country's market for manufactured goods. At the same time, Britain's agriculture was developing like never before in history. New and more modern techniques were used to cultivate more food using fewer people in the country fields. English farmers were second only to the Dutch in terms of agricultural production, which helped people move to other economic activities. Innovation was beginning to be part of the equation. More food and high wages meant more opportunities for people in society. Without working just to eat, people could use their money in other things like manufactured goods. At the same time, education was expanding and women began to incorporate themselves into the job market. Britain also had immense natural resources. Moving goods by water was cheaper than by land, and no big town in the country was more than 50 miles away from navigable waters. Additionally, in the 18th century, the crown invested money developing infrastructure like canals that further developed water transportation. Since the country had a lot of iron and coal, and the possibility of quickly moving these resources, there were incentives to develop technologies to improve production and create new industries. The vast amount of resources increased wages, and manufacturers preferred to invest money in developing new technologies, which did not happen in India or China because labor was much cheaper. The final element that distinguished Britain from other places was public policy. The British state regulated taxes and commerce and invested money to protect the imperial fleet that was pivotal for its mercantilist system. Workers were controlled and sometimes repressed to prevent any rebellion. Aggressive tariffs on import goods were adopted to protect British industries. All these factors combined to help Great Britain be at the front of the Industrial Revolution. The inventions and technical advance of this era went hand in hand with a remarkable advancement of industrial growth, especially after 1801. The pressure to produce more goods for a growing market helped develop and create the first machine power factories and industries. The sector of the economy that first set was the textile industry. The technological advance in these sectors of the economy led to a new production system and new social relationships. The textile industry transitioned from being developed in individual households to bigger shops, in the beginning only having raw materials like wool and flax. The process was complicated, but with the arrival of cotton, everything changed. Cotton textiles were first imported to Great Britain from China and India, where the material was popular. At first, considered a luxury, cotton quickly popularized, and the demand for this type of textiles rapidly grew. By 1760, a domestic cotton industry developed to supply the market. The industry invested money in inventing new technologies to compete with Indian and Chinese manufacturers. In 1765, James Hargreaves invented the spinning jenny, a simple power-by-hand machine that made cotton processing easier. This machine was the first of many advancements that revolutionized the industry. The jenny easily separates the cotton seeds from the fiber. Until the mid-18th century, most energy available in the world was from wood, and humans or domestic animals usually performed the hard work. However, it was in the late 18th century when this state of affairs changed with the discovery of new sources of energy. The most important of these new energies was coal. The material had been used since the 17th century to heat houses or make glass, but in the 18th century, it began to be used to produce mechanical energy and to power machinery. In 1763, a worker at the University of Glasgow named James Watt redesigned the steam engine, making it a practical and commercial success in England. Watt's invention was the most revolutionary technology of the era. For the first time in history, human beings had unlimited power at their disposal. The steam engine directly impacted the textile industry, flour mills, breweries, and pottery shops. Thanks to the steam power, the British iron industry transformed, becoming more efficient and producing much more than ever before. In just over 100 years, from 1740 to 1840, Britain went from producing 17,000 tons to 3 million tons of iron a year. In 1804, Richard Trevithick invented the first steam locomotive. Within a couple of years, steam power transportation was revolutionizing the world. The first modern railroad connected Liverpool and Manchester in 1829. 30 years later, the whole country was connected by railroad. The same thing happened in other places like Brazil, Chile, Argentina, Canada, Australia, and India. The impact of the railroad was remarkable. Until that moment, most markets were local, but with the barrier of high transportation costs gone, it was easy to move products at a national and international scale. With broader markets, manufacturers had to have bigger factories and employ more people. In all countries, the construction of railroads created a strong demand for unskilled labor and contributed to the growth of a new class of urban workers. Having more than two-thirds of the world's coal and more than half of the iron and the cotton, Britain became the most powerful country in the world. 20% of the world's industrial goods were British too. That type of economic leadership triggered an unprecedented population boom. The country went from having 9 million people in 1780 to 21 million in 1851. A bigger population meant more and cheaper labor. Young people all over were willing to go where the jobs were, and urbanization flourished. The new wealth made many people very rich, but also many people suffer, which continues to be one of modernity's most significant contradictions. This is all I have for you today. Thank you, and I'll see you next time.